Good evening. I am Atalanta Canapis. I'm the Lord Chair this evening. I'm going to briefly introduce all our panel members. In fact, I've just seen one who's just come in at the back. First of all, can I just thank all the panel members? Robin, who I'll start with. Robin Howard, the barrister, sits on my right. He gallantly stepped up 2 nights ago when some other barrister who was supposed to be here sadly couldn't make it. So, great thank you to Robin. Professor Andrew sits next to him, Mavis Maclean sits next to Andy Boone, and Keelan Gallagher, who's just joined us, also a barrister, on the end. Before I tell you a little bit more about our speakers, I'd just like to say the humanity of barristers is not something people generally think about or talk about. More common are portrayals, whether it's in the press or emanating from the Ministry of Justice, of fat cat lawyers, or clever, slippery-tongued advocates who are cool and detached. Well, these characterisations are clearly very one-dimensional, rather unfair, simplistic, and they ignore the complexity of the barrister's professional role, the ethics that underpin their thoughts and their actions, and the difficult real-life situations in which they perform as professionals and as people. So, what we hope this evening is that our distinguished panel will paint a more nuanced and human picture of what it is to be a barrister and what it is to carry out a barrister's role. I'm just going to give you a little bit more information about everyone who I introduced earlier. Robin Howard is a barrister in 1 Grayson Square. He was called in 1986. He's a general civil practitioner. He undertakes a wide variety of work related to employment, business and property, or as he puts it, anything but family. Areas of work include sale of goods, supply of services, construction claims, insurance, insolvency, directors' liability, shareholders' remedies, and in the employment arena, he deals with all forms of discrimination, dismissal and redundancy. He's an accredited mediator, and he accepts public access instructions, and he has been described as a tenacious and effective. Professor Andy Boo joined City Law School in September 2012. Before that, he was Dean of the School of Law at the University of Westminster. He was Education Advisor to the General Counsel of the Bar and the Chair of the Bar Vocational Course Board. He recently was a consultant to the Law Society of England and Wales on introducing legal ethics to the compulsory curriculum for undergraduates and to the Solicitors Regulation Authority on the Mandatory Scheme for Continuing Professional Development. He is a founding director of the International Legal Ethics Association. And tonight, Andy will talk about the narratives of legal professionalism and the rule of law. Mavis Maclean is the founding director of the Oxford Centre for Family Law and Policy, the Department of Social Policy and Intervention. She's a senior research fellow at St Hilda's College in Oxford and the joint editor of the Journal of Social Welfare and Family Law. Mavis has written many books, and I'm only going to mention one tonight, which she co-wrote in 2009. Called Family Law Advocacy, How Barristers Help the Victims of Family Failure, which is of particular relevance, I think, for our theme tonight. So tonight, Mavis will expand on that, telling us how family barristers deal with clients who are more often than not in a state of extreme distress when they get to court, and what role do barristers play in the negotiations and settlements of family disputes and cases, and what support, if any, do they receive? Keelan Gallagher, who sits at the end, is a barrister. She was called in 2001 and she's a member of Downton Street Chambers. Keelan specialises in human rights and civil liberties work. She regularly acts at inquests for bereaved families whose loved ones have died in circumstances which raise concerns about the failure of state agencies. Her current cases include acting in the Hillsborough inquests and for the family of Connor Sparrowhawk, whose death sparked the Justice for LD campaign. In the field of children's rights, she has secured many important changes to the law for her clients and others. I'll give you one example in the case of R and Home Secretary 2014. It was a test case which recognised that 17-year-olds in police custody should be treated as children, not adults, and they should be given additional support and protections. This is now available to 70,000 17-year-olds in custody every year. Many of her cases are sensitive and concern issues of national security. For example, she acted for bereaved families as survivor of the 7/7 London bombings and for national media organisations in the Gareth Williams inquest, which you may recall was regarding the unexplained death a GCHQ employee found dead in a holdall at his Columbia flat. She's authored a number of books, and before coming to the bar, she worked as an academic and a civil liberties campaigner. So those are our live and present speakers, but before they do anything, we've actually got a short film made by Dr. Justine Rogers, who's a lecturer in the University of New South Wales in Sydney, where she was appointed to design its core ethics course, Lawyers, Ethics and Justice. Justine's research focuses on lawyers' identities and well-being, ethical decision-making, and the changes to the legal profession. In 2007, the reason we've asked Justine to join us long distance tonight, Justine carried out an ethnographic study of pupil barristers, which meant that she spent 3 months shadowing pupils in 3 different sets of chambers. And clearly, during those 3 months, she also observed what all the other barristers were doing and interviewed them. So she's going to tell us first, in this little pre-recorded film, a little about her findings and how they link to our theme.